Hello and welcome to a new YouTube video. Today we're gonna review the Sanyo CRT. And yeah, I'm gonna tell you how I found this. I was basically outside in a forest and I found an abandoned house. Like a really nasty mold. The house that had been abandoned since 2004. And in the attic of that house I found this television. And I was like, it's a knob tuning TV, that's interesting. So I brought it home to see if it worked. And if I could make it work if it didn't. And yeah, I only needed to clean these controls to make it operational. But yeah, we're gonna take a tour around it. So here we have the tube, it's a black and white tube. There we have a headphone jack and the Sanyo logo. Yeah, here we have a power button and volume button. Yeah, I'm gonna show you how this works. Now it's in the off position, but when we turn up the volume, we power the TV on. Yeah, there we have a contrast and brightness and the knob. So this knob is gonna be right there to put it in the UHF band. Yeah, this knob is loose too. And yeah, when you just have it here, you're on the VHF band. And you also have a fine tune control there for the VHF band. And a knob right there to tune it in the UHF band. And yeah, now we're gonna turn the TV on. I have already plugged an N64 into it to demonstrate the picture quality. Let me turn up the volume. And yeah, the quality is quite shitty because it's in black and white. I'm gonna show you this. If we turn this knob, we can fine tune this. As you can see.
Message from General Pepper.
Let's turn that down.
We need your help, Starbucks.
There you can see the picture quality. And yeah, those, like, rolling bars or whatever does not exist in real life. It's just me filming the screen. Let me see. Yeah, there you can see the picture quality. We can adjust the contrast and brightness. Yeah, I think the tube in this is like really weak, if I'm gonna be honest with you. Cause yeah, this TV is from the 60s and it has probably been used like a lot. But yeah, now I'm gonna show you the back and inside of the TV. Okay, here is the back. We have some information. Some information in German. Achtung vor Arbeiter. I can't read German, sorry. And yeah, there we have a horizontal and vertical hold. Height. And I don't know what that is. I'm not sure. DC 12 volt input if you want to use it. Well, I don't know what it can be for. I don't think. At first I thought it was like a 12 volt plug you plugged into a car, you know, via those, yeah, sockets in the car. But yeah, in the 60s, I don't think 12 volt adapters in cars existed, so I'm not sure what that can be used for other than to run it from a DC adapter, which I don't see the point of. Unless you want to use it in the car, which obviously no one did in the 60s. Yeah, here we have an antenna, which is useless nowadays because analog TV has not been around since like 2010. And yeah, here we have a socket for this internal antenna, which you can't use for anything because yeah, analog TV has not been around since 2010, as I mentioned. And yeah, we have some vents. And yeah, now I'm gonna take this TV apart. Okay, not really a lot of screws to get into the TV. One screw right there. And yeah, two screws in each corner. And yeah, a screw right there. And also a plug for the antenna. Because yeah, the antenna is like integrated into this back piece. But yeah, now I'm gonna show you the inside of this TV. Let me flip it up for you. And yeah, here's the inside of a CRT. We have a transformer right there. It is actually old enough to have IC chips, because yeah, some stuff in the 50s and 60s used tubes, but yeah, this is actually switched to caps and IC chips. So yeah, this is probably like late 60s, I would guess. Yeah, here is the antenna part. Which is wired up like that. And there is the VHF and UHF tuners. There is the UHF one and there is the VHF one. There we have a little speaker. And the controls for the TV. The tube, which is made by Orion. And not Sanyo. And yeah. I'm gonna say this. CRTs are like very dangerous to mess around with. I'm gonna explain how this works. So you can see this little tube right here. It shoots stuff out on this TV. And this deflection yoke shoots the picture like this. Because it draws the picture very fast like that. And yeah, then those electrodes that the TV shoots out goes back into this flyback transformer. And yeah, this flyback contains like a really high voltage. There is the flyback. And yeah, the flyback contains like really high voltage, and it goes back into the TV using this little like lead right there, if you can see it. And yeah, there is how the flyback looks like. Yeah, we're gonna have a look. Some Sanyo capacitors, Ruby Concap, it looks like right there. And yeah, this has like shitty circuit glue inside of it, which was often used back in the day. And yeah, often this like turns corrosive and corrodes the boards and stuff. And yeah. This is how... It doesn't look like this TV has a degaussing coil, because yeah, often there's like a degaussing coil to degauss the tube in the CRT, but this one doesn't have a degaussing coil, which is pretty weird. But yeah, it only has like that silver bar, which is quite strange in my opinion. But yeah, this is how the inside of this CRT looks like. And yeah, this has been the review, and thanks a lot for watching.